Hello, welcome to another episode of Calorie Darsana. Today I'm going to show you the first form long stick northern style, a rabokai. Okay, I will explain you that in blocks like I did with other videos. Before I do the blocks, I will show you how to hold the long stick. So your knuckles are up and you keep it like this. If you are going to hit somebody, you're going to glide your hand to one side and give it a blow. Like this. So if you want to beat with the right side of the stick, you're going to glide your right hand towards the left. Like this. And then the stick comes automatically forward. Okay, the first block will be three hits. So, one up, one down, again one up. If you look at the feet, my left foot is front, and my first encounter, my first join with the opponent, is with my stick in my right hand, and my left hand front, my right hand back, and my left foot also front, like this. Then with a half circle, a semicircle, circle down in order for the defense. So half circle again, up. Then you're going to change your stick by stepping forward. So he's stepping forward. One. And you come two, three. Again, it's two half circles. Again, he steps back. One, two, three. He steps towards me. One, two, three. In the next block, it is a sequence which I will use the first block. So I will start off with two hits. One, two. I'm not going to step. Then I go down. One, two. Again, I change stick. One, one, two, three. Again, I repeat. You join the sticks. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Again, so up two. So two times I hit up. One, two, then down. Three. Four, change, five, six, seven, eight, join again. Okay, eight, there are 10 hits. Eight we have done now. So actually it's a composite of the previous one. So I do two up, and then I do, from the first block, I do first right part, and then I do the left part. But I'm not moving, so I'm not going to step towards my opponent, or I'm not going to step back. I stay on my place. Okay, then we are going to the last part. There are two blocks. It goes like this. One, two. When I reach this, I, as the attacker, take the stick and swirl it over my head. Like this. In this position. He's going to stick his head in the floor. Why? Really in the floor, so that it does not move. So when I'm going to rotate the stick around my head, I'm going to give a blow here on the stick. It should not move. So it should be in this angle. You see, it will not move. Because the floor will hold the power which I enforce against the stick. Okay, so again, it is one. I, as the attacker, go around my head. I do it like this. I put my hands together, and I the tail of the stick, I put a little bit forward, and I put it completely around, rotate it around my head like this. And from the shoulder, I give a blow, like this. Okay, then what is his response? So I'm doing the same thing, but he's doing this to me at this moment. So, one, two. He's going to rotate his stick. I'm going to put it in the floor. I'm going to, that's right. You're going to blow my stick. Now, what am I going to do? I'm going to use my stick as a kind of shovel. I'm going to put my stick under it, stick it up, and with a round movement, I'm going with a circle, complete circle, I put the stick to the other side to create an opening here. Because when I'm here, I'm very easy. I can blow his face, give a blow on his face. Okay, again, I will repeat it, this one. Because it's a little bit difficult movement. Can you, the blow is here. Yeah. The blow is here. So, here is the stick. I'm not just take a stick and put it to the other side. No, what I'm going to do differently. First, I have my hands like this. My knuckles are in this direction. As soon as you just blow it, I will turn the stick a little bit. I rotate the stick a little bit too. The right. So, and the little finger is the most important thing in this movement. So I go a little bit round like this. My middle finger, my little finger will point towards the floor. Like this. Then, I'm going to go under his stick, like this. Keep your little finger like this, pointing to the floor. Then, I'm going to lift his stick, like this. And I push it here, and I push a little bit towards his hands, like this. So I really want to hurt him. Because when I push to his hands, when I do it with a little bit force, I will reach his hands, and when I press it a little bit, the stick will drop out of his hands, like this. Okay, again, put your stick against my stick. Yes? So, I rotate this direction. My little finger is pointing to the floor. So, I'm going to rotate my little finger to the floor. I'm going to spoon up, as it were, or shovel up his stick, like this, in this direction. I'm going to push, 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 and I have it here. Now, you see, my little finger is pointing towards his direction. So again, I'm going to turn. My little finger is pointing to the floor, floor, floor. Now it's pointing to that direction. And I have put the stick to the other side. Okay, why do I give so much attention to the little finger? The little finger is the secret to this movement. If you have the little finger right, you are controlling the stick. If you don't pay attention to this small detail, you will never ever be able to put his stick from one side to the other side in the right manner. You know, you put your stick on my stick. If I don't do it, I can try to lift, 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 but if he is really blowing to it, I cannot. I'm here, and he is on my hand here. So I'm the victim of my own attack. So he's going to hurt me. I don't want to do that. So I'm going to twist the thing, and I'm going to here. Now he is there. Now the stick is here, going around, and it goes to the other side. So it's a very small detail, but you should really pay attention to it. So the second block goes as follows. If I put this last part and the first part together, I get it like this. So we step join. One, two, down, up. Three, four, down, up. Okay? Now we step back. One. Step back. Two. I'm going to go around. He sticks his hand, his stick to the floor. One. I'm going to blow. I try to give a blow to his legs. But he is defending his legs like this. So he's going to now also adjust this thing. And hop, my stick is almost falling out of my hands. It doesn't need much force. It will just go by itself. And again, we join. So this was block two. The third block is as follows. I'm standing here. I pull my stick back like this. And I'm going. While I'm doing that, I'm going to step forward and release the stick while I'm I'm gliding with my right hand back to my left side, like this. It's an attack through the center line, and his defense is like this. So he stretches out his arms. When I'm touching, at the moment I touch his stick, his arms should be stretched to the maximum in order to minimize the impact of the blow. So timing is very important with weapons in general, but especially when you have an impact like this. So I, and you can hear it. When I, when he doesn't do the, his, when he doesn't stretch his arms on the right moment, like this, you hear tick tick tick. And that is when it goes wrong. You should hear one click when you beat the stick, when you hit the stick. It goes like this. Yes. I hear only one, so not several of these beating hits after each other. So that is one thing. So again, this was the first part. Again, I'm going to pull stick back like this. Same technique as I did. Now I'm going to give a blow like this. So I release the stick in this way. And I blow to the floor like this. So first I release the stick like this. Now I release the stick also from the shoulder like this and give him a blow to the ankle. So the whole thing looks like this. So first I pull my stick back, I give a blow to the central line. Here, it went wrong. Then I put it back and I give the same. He puts his stick on the floor and my stick glides like this to his ankles while I give a step like this. So, do it like this. Then I pull back and that's the end of block three. Now I'm going to show you the form. The form starts off like this. So you keep your hands like this, your feet together, like he is standing. Then you put your hand so like this, your fist a little bit above your eyes, like this. You bow to each other. It's a sign of respect. It's a part of martial arts, so we're doing it. And you're going to stand in the middle between a horse and a lion. So you go a little bit down in your legs, like this. Then you go do the second block. You start off. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2. Bam. He's going to then join. Then I step backwards and you go to the 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Join. Then again. Block. 2. 1, 2. Down. Up. 1, 2. Down. Up. 1, 2. Now. We are reached, so we started off with block two. We did 3 steps to this side. And then we did again block two. Come a little bit back, so. Now I have to do 3 steps back again. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. And again, we start off with block two. 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1. I'm going to blow like this. Now again, he's going to we're going to do 3 steps to that side. It's just a repetition for the third time. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1. And again, we're doing the second block. two, three. So you're going to do it again. Okay, now reach here. I take my stick in my hand, like this. I put it back. So I have it in my right hand, my left hand, foot is front. Then I'm going to give an overhead blow. And he's going to defend like he does, like this. So again, I take it back, I give an overhead blow. Then I again put it back here, because I try to give a blow to his feet. Like this. And then the form is finished. This was the first form, long stick. The following forms, it is the basic of all the short sticks formed Northern style. It will, each form is dedicated to a special technique of the long stick. So you will end up doing the same form, but every time you add a small technique to it. So if you learn this well, then you know how the system works, and the other forms will be very easy for you. Thank you very much for watching, and see you next time. Bye.